Alright folks, today we are grilling this awesome looking apple jalapeno pulled pork. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. Let's get started with chopping up some onions. Exactly 3 onions today. We need a lot of onions for this dish. Of course, as always, I have speed this up a little bit for you. Otherwise, cutting veggies is a little bit boring. In the meantime, we have already put our Dutch oven into our Landmann charcoal kettle. If you want to cook a Dutch oven pulled pork, you need some liquids in there, and the onions are perfect for the beginning. This is our pork neck. In Germany, we have the cut of a neck, which is close to butt and not shoulder. Shoulder will work great as well. This is 2.3 kilogram of Duroc. We add some mustard as a little bit of a glue and adds, of course, flavor. The glue for the barbecue rub, sprinkle over your favorite barbecue rub. Might be a little bit some sweet or spicy stuff, which works perfect. Now place the pork roast inside your Dutch oven. And then add some soy sauce and some jalapeno pickled vinegar. This is enough liquid inside that. Close the lid and add some amber or charcoal briquettes, as I use them. Put some on top and put the rest below. I usually add between 12 or 16 on top, sometimes more, sometimes less. It doesn't have to be perfect. The shoulder or the pork meat really is not very complicated in cooking. Just make sure not to burn it too quickly. It could get a little bit darker during cooking time, but in the beginning it should be not too much heat. This is how it looks like after 2 hours. The total cooking time today is between 4 or 5 hours. In the meantime, you could give it a turn or a flip. And just make sure to have enough water, liquid or whatever in there. If you feel there's too less, add some beer, add some broth, whatever you like. We are close, getting there. Another hour. The heat starts to get less. That's why I added some more of that briquettes for the last 45 minutes. The pro of cooking pulled pork in a Dutch oven is that you can save all the fat renderings, the grease and the drippings of the pork, and it really is a nice beginning for a sauce. The disadvantage is that you don't have smoke flavor. I now changed the setup. I made a basket full of charcoal briquettes again. Then I take out the pulled pork and then I put the liquids with the onions into a cast iron pan. Heat it up again. Add ketchup and barbecue sauce. Give it a good mix. Now you have to give it a try if it's too salty or not. Just add some more of that ketchup for sweetness. And as I mentioned, it's an apple jalapeno pulled pork. That's why we are adding apple puree. 5 or 6 spoons of apple puree will add a nice fruit flavor to your sauce. If you feel like, add some more salt or barbecue rub. I felt in that moment we need some more of that flavor. Give it a good mix and let that simmer for approximately 8 till 10 minutes. The sauce should have a nice and creamy consistency later on. Toast some buns and then pull your pork. Really juicy stuff here. I usually take spoons or some of that pulled pork claws in the beginning. The moment it has cooled down a little bit, I'm doing this with my hands. Looks delicious, really tender, really juicy. Now let's build the burger. We have the pre-toasted bun, we have some of that really rich flavor sauce. Make sure to have a good amount of pork for your burger. This should be enough. Some more of that wonderful sauce. I like to add French onions for a nice crunch and some additional sweetness. And of course, pickled jalapenos. And there you go, this is your apple jalapeno pulled pork burger. Looks good or what? Okay, I'll show you some close-ups and then I'm gonna give this a shot as always. Really good, I like that. Please make sure to hit that like button, leave me a comment. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure to subscribe now. We are seeing us again in the upcoming days, I promise. You can also visit my fan pages anyway. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.